morning, students. I am your social study teacher Neha Sen. Students, I hope you are healthy and you are staying at home for the maximum. Children, back to the study. If you remember, we were doing chapter number 9, Women, Caste and Reform in the history book. Till now we have discussed certain topics like how the women were getting education, how they were writing in the book about the present situation of the women of the upper caste, about the widows, and how things were changing. They now were able to enter the universities for education. They were getting training to become doctors. Some became teachers also. So this was a very good change, we can say. As the time was passing, they were getting independent. They were becoming independent. But you know, one more problem, one more issue was prevailing there, other than the situation of the girls and the women. That was the caste system. There was a system that they had divided people into caste, upper caste, lower caste, religion. You are Brahmin, you are Muslim, these. They had divided and everybody was not being treated equally. Everybody was not getting the rights equally. So a lot of people from a certain group were facing problems. So today the topic for discussion is the demand for equality and justice. In this, according to the book in the chapter, it is discussed that in the second half of the 19th century, the people from the Brahmin group, they started a movement. That movement was regarding the discrimination among themselves. They demanded social equality and justice. They were facing problem because certain rites, certain rituals, certain things they were not allowed to do. So collectively they started a movement and demanded for justice and social equality, because these all things we have only made. There is no fault to be a Brahmin. So it was all about the social justice and reform. The other thing was that there was a movement known as the Satnami movement in the central area, founded by the Ghanidas. They were the leather workers. They were also facing so many problems. They were not treated equally. They were treated like they are making in the leather form. They were facing inferiority complex. They were not being treated with the upper caste people very properly. So this movement also was about the justice and the social status. They also wanted to be equally treated as the other caste people. Those two things, children, place now in present day Kerala, there was one person from the Ezhava caste, a guru from the Ezhava caste. He also proclaimed that their people, the people from this caste, are not getting equality, they are not getting the freedom, they are not enjoying the rights, they are not being taken as important different as the other caste people. There was discrimination for this caste also. So he also proclaimed that they should get the equal status. They should equally be standing with the other religions. So there was overall a demand for the equality and justice. Students, as you will move forward in the book, you will come across a term in the chapter Ghulam Giri, which means slavery. So what is all this all about? Let us discuss. So students, there was one person, his name was Jyotirao Phule. He was born in 1827 and he got his education through the school which was built by the Christians. So he was highly educated and he had got good education. So he knew that there is discrimination going on with the lower caste people and the slaves of Africa, the black slaves, the people who were in black, they were facing the same discrimination as the lower caste people were facing in India. So he dedicated a book to them and the name of the book was Satya Hosh Donak Samaj. This was the book which was written in 1873 by Jyotirao Phule. So students, I hope you have understood that how the people now started raising their voice to get justice and to enjoy the rights, and how the situation day by day started in a positive way. So till now we have discussed from this chapter that things were changing day by day because people were getting education, there were reformers who were telling about and they were taking stand for these people, for the girls, for the lower caste people, for the widows. So things were changing. That is all about this chapter till now. For the further topics from the same chapter, we will meet in the next video. Till then, please read the chapter from the book, read the worksheets, join the live classes, and be safe. Take care. Thank you.